Hey guys, I always get these questions from beginners whether or not they think Tegu is a great beginner pet. So today I want to talk to you guys about whether or not if a Tegu is actually suitable for you or if it's actually the right pet for you. Although they may seem as brilliant pets, they take a lot of commitment and time and money as well. Let's start by talking about the different species of tegus they have available on the market. This one right here is a Colombian gold tegu. You can tell that the snout is a lot more sharper in comparison to some other tegus that you would see. And if you want to get more advanced, you can tell that the number of scales in the snout defies that they are Colombian tegus. Although they are the same family of tegus, they cost a lot more less and are reported as more aggressive. Personally, I have never been bitten by an Argentine tegu, but I have definitely been bitten by an adult Colombian tegu. Prices for these animals ranges around $50. This one is also a Colombian tegu, but a black and white Colombian tegu. They are the same species but with different paint jobs. Now, I have personally owned an adult Colombian tegu before, and even though he was the tamest Colombian tegu I've ever seen in my life, I still got a nasty bite from him. These ranges around $50 to $100. This is my boy Zilla. He is an Argentine black and white tegu. Argentine tegus tend to have the best reputation on being the most docile out of all species of tegus. Now, I personally do recommend this the most for any person who is looking forward into getting a tegu. Although they might be a bit more pricey than the Colombians, it's definitely worth it. They do grow larger than Colombians. Colombians normally range at the size of 2 to 3 foot, whereas Argentines can go to 4 to 5, to some extent 6 foot. Their prices ranges from $150 to $200. This is my red Argentine tegu, Kimchi. Now, there are some people who record as saying that red Argentine tegus actually grow larger to black and whites. Personally, I am on the fence on this belief, but I guess I'll find out soon enough, won't I? Red tegus normally are born in the hatchling of brownish colors, and the red colors come by the older they get. Males tend to be a lot redder than females as well. These guys' prices range from $200 to $300. This here is a blue tegu. Now, although you can tell they're not actually blue, they are known for quote-unquote blue for the high whites on their body. Some people believe that they grow larger or are more docile in comparison to the Argentine tegus. This is not scientifically proven, so I really wouldn't go by it. This species of tegu is normally not recommended for beginners, as they do range from a high price from $600 or higher. It really depends on the age that you buy the tegu at, but normally this would be left for more advanced people. Providing a very proper diet for your tegus is of great importance to their growth and health. Now, normally I provide chicken fillet dusted in calcium powder for my tegus, but occasionally I would feed them pinkies, rat pups, and also adult mice. Reason being is that tegus actually need bones and organs for them as a nutrition. It's a requirement as they do eat these things in the wild. Chicken fillet is actually pretty cheap or easy to find in grocery stores, so it's actually not that hard to find for your tegus. Just make sure you cut it up in the right sizes. Fruits. Oftentimes, tegu owners tend to forget that their tegus actually need fruits in their diets as well. Veggies, I tend to find that tegus don't like as much. My tegus personally like berries the most. Strawberries, blueberries, and especially cherries. Occasionally, they will eat some bananas and mangoes as well. Make sure you read for the care sheets which fruits you should be providing for your tegus. It's actually great importance to your diet. Insects. This should actually be the stable diet for your tegus from hatchling to young juvenile stages. As they grow older, you can start cutting them off from eating insects. My tegu, Kimchi, actually still likes occasional mealworms in his diet, where Zilla still actually provides, which I provide for as a staple diet, crickets, mealworms, waxworms, and other captive-bred insects for food are great. But of course, out of all those foods, you definitely have to remember to provide your tegus vitamins. I personally like to use this brand of vitamins for them. I dust their chicken fillets and their mealworms before feeding it to them every single week. Now, make sure that your tegus have a great amount of vitamins and calcium with D3. Feeding tegus aren't exactly the cheapest idea ever. They eat a lot, and they actually require a large range of different diets. So make sure that you buy the right things in order for your safety and the health of your tegu, or else you'll be taking a trip to the vet very quickly. Biting. People tend to underestimate how hard a tegu can actually bite. They can pack quite a punch. And actually, I have been bitten by an adult Colombian tegu. Colombian tegus are normally known to be more aggressive, so it was pretty bad when I got the bite. Now, biting can be overcome with easier within Argentine tegus from more handling, whereas Colombians definitely are a larger challenge. Here are some examples of photos of people who have been bitten by their tegus. As you can tell by the bite marks, their tegus weren't exactly adults either. In some serious cases, a tegu bite can break your finger depending on how hungry they are, or send you to hospital from stitches. Another thing that people tend to underestimate about is the size of the enclosure you should be providing for your tegu. Now let's say you own an adult Argentine tegu that is around 4 foot. You should be providing an enclosure that ranges about 6 to 8 foot long. This is actually a requirement, and your tegu would be very unhappy and at a very slow growth rate if you do not provide such a cage. Now if you look inside this picture, you can see the size comparison to the human, whereas how much space a tegu cage can actually take. Not to mention, you will have to provide a basking UVA light and also a UVB light for ultraviolet in order for their calcium to go through. Those put together can go over thousands of dollars, so that is something that people actually have to consider it about. It also depends on whether you're building one yourself or you're buying a custom one. Alright, enough with all the negativity. Now let's talk about how you can bond with your new tegus once you've decided that tegu is actually right for you. Now, let's go through how you should handle your tegus. Sometimes, they like a little neck rub. As you can see Kimchi over here, he doesn't really like it when you touch his head sometimes, especially when he's trying to explore around. For a size like tegu, like Kimchi right here, you want to make sure that you hold the hind legs and you hold the front part of its chest. Make sure that you support both ends of the tegu. Now let's demonstrate with Zilla over here. Have your hand, go in front of the tegu, make sure they can see your hand coming, cup them upwards, and slide your hand from the back and make sure that you support all four legs. Now they're comfortable and secure and sitting still in your hand. Now say hello to Zilla. Random. There are four main stages that a tegu can go through when it first comes to your home, or even sooner or later within your home. There is being scared, there is dislike to you, there is a liking to you, and there is a loving to you. Right here, Kimchi is showing between a liking and a loving to me. Let's take a look exactly how much Kimchi does trust me. A tame tegu should allow you to hold it by his back legs only and should be sitting upright just like a human would be. Now, as you can see, Kimchi is enjoying a nice little chin rub right here, and obviously I have my finger at the back to support his spine and supporting his legs so he doesn't feel like he will be falling. A tame tegu would allow you to have him lying on his back while he's enjoying having his owner handling him. Now, a pretty tame tegu would allow you to cut his nails with no problem. Zilla over here, I haven't had as long as kimchi, so he definitely doesn't trust me as much as kimchi would. As you can see, he's feeling a bit uncomfortable with me cutting his nails, so he's moving around everywhere. Make sure that you comfort, speak to your Tegu in sweet words, talk to him, and make sure that he's comfortable and know that you are harmless. After a while, he will sit still and let you cut his nails continuously. Zilla over here is a good boy. He still needs a bit more taming to do though. If you feel that you are more than intermediate, you can actually go along and purchase an Argentine black and white Tegu like this one, a hatchling that still has its green colorations, and you can start by taming process then. It does make things a little bit more easier, but again, taking care of a hatchling may become more complicated and harder. To help enhance your bonding process, while you're watching TV or just chilling out, you should have some little cuddle time with your Tegus, just like Zilla here. Now, I have to mention though, you should start by scratching under their chin. Make sure that your Tegu can see your hand coming towards them so that they know you're not at any threat. You can also scratch on their back, just because they feel a bit more secure about their back. There are some behavior that people don't understand about Tegus. When a Tegu is only closing one eye towards you, it normally means that they are in stress and are hoping you to go away by closing and shutting you off by the eye that they are seeing you at. Now you can see Kimchi over here, being a very bonded Tegu, he's actually enjoying a back scratch and falling asleep very, very quickly on my belly. We do this almost every day, so it's his daily routine and his comfort with his own owner. This is a video of when Kimchi was still a baby and when I first got him. I tried to bathe him in the water, but it turns out all he wanted to do was just to climb back right up on my arm. This shows a quick bonding process between owners and Tegus. I've had Kimchi for about a month by this time. A truly bonded Tegu can actually learn to come when called. Now, Kimchi over here is actually curious onto what I'm doing, until he realizes that I'm actually telling him to come out for food. I have some blueberries prepared on the floor, so he'll come over. But sometimes, when I don't actually have food, he'll just take a look at me and continue on to what he's doing. He's a little pig sometimes. Overall, Tegus are my favorite kind of lizards. They're actually one of the only lizards that can process affection within their brain capacity. If you guys have any more questions, please feel free to inbox me.